Doom Hunter base. Not ominous or anything. Not at all. Okay, challenges. Find the collectible album. Use the auto map. Kill 3 demons with a single fragment.
The Hell Priest's position is stable now, and his guardian is some facility ahead.
I guess I don't even get a map yet. Must have just floating drones or something. And HP. And explosions. And armor. Is that everything? Nope, there's something way up there. No idea how I'm gonna get to that. Probably from Hunter. Over here, for example. Thingy. Lock on burst. That's probably useful. Just fairly. Gimme. Okay. There should be everything for this. Oh, that was close. Okay. What else do we have? Combat. Lots of it. Pinky!
Okay, so when in doubt, get angry and punch things.
Why did I use the chain gun? Think so.
By the way, Ran, those praying cultists that you ran into earlier in that level were meant to be free armor and health.
That would have been useful.
Because, you know, murder. I really need to get good.
What am I? Oh, I'm out of super shotgun ammo. I should have figured that from the first one. Thank you.
I pulled a massive fucking derp. What the fuck? Damn it! Note to self, make sure you have the right... Make sure you have the right weapon mod equipped.
Yeah, that has to be important, huh? More HP. This is a much more intense battle than I thought it would be. I'm playing on normal.
I'm playing on ultra violent.
Sounds like get fucked.
That hurt. Getting pinned into a corner is bad.
Okay, that was really nice.
But yeah, by the way, in case you can't tell, game is delayed.
Well, yeah.
Chronicles is happening tomorrow.
Look, Doom is out. Of course it's delayed. Anything else is delayed. Oh lord. Doom Hunter Base. Ooh. Look at that entry. The UAC's Polar Cultist facility is built around the ruins of an ancient Argenta settlement constructed over 60 million years ago. During Argentinur's extraterrestrial expansion, frozen carcasses of their Agadon hunters have been located in the glacial wastes surrounding the complex. And though their DNA structure reveals them to be indigenous to Earth, there is no fossilized record of these creatures beyond the frozen territories of the Argenta settlement. Carbon dating of the remarkably well-preserved beasts suggests that they are nearly 80 million years old, predating all other known forms of complex Earth-based life. Continuing the cyber-demonic experimentation that began on Mars, the cultists study the Agadon's potential for resurrection and cyber-augmentation. A similar program occurred at this location millennia ago, when the Ag priests, often cited as Hell priests, bred the creatures and genetically modified them to function as Doom Hunters, fearsome mutants designed to battle the Doomslayer and his Night Sentinels during the Unholy Crusades on Argentina. Sentinel records corroborate this through the military text, and with many reports of these creatures among the ranks of the demonic forces assaulting the armies of the North during the Argenta Civil War. once the UEC cultist movement publicly announced its intentions for Earth, the cyber demonic program was revealed to be focused on updating the Doom Hunter schematics, upgrading their combat prowess. A new assembly center was constructed near the cultist facility, and a powerful craft drum allowed UEC workers to safely transport the biological and mechanical components needed for the process. The resurrection of an Agadon Hunter requires cutting-edge technology be used in conjunction with occult rituals conducted by the UEC's necrosurgeons, an unholy fusion of science and sorcery. Okay then. Sounds like something
Sorry.
I must kill.
Sorry for interrupting you.
It's fine.
It was not easy to find an opponent worthy of the Slayer, but I think you will
make sure
impressed.
I've got the right weapon mods equipped. Yep.
Are we fighting floaters now? Hey, the Tama. So I guess I'll be there later. What are you? Should I shoot it? Sounds like it.
Curse you, muscle memory.
I guess that was not the right way.
Ow!
Oh, just get on. Oh, come on.
Don't you just love it when muscle memory from the previous game rears its ugly head and you try to swap weapon mods and instead use your flamethrower on nothing?
Yeah, that is that. Don't you hate it when the melee button and the grab onto wall buttons are the same?
I don't have that problem because I just dash into walls.
I mean, yeah, there is that too, but there are some cases in which you can't. Which makes it a bit more difficult. Que codimos fuera si os les hace ver.
I forgot that you can use dash for as part of a combat maneuver.
The challenge is going to be the death of me. Possibly quite literally. Okay, so that's that section complete. you know that guy who failed to do the tutorial in Cuphead? I don't think he'd be able to do this at all.
Oh, you mean the guy who also tried his hand at Doom Eternal and got lost in one of the platforming sections that wasn't that hard?
Yeah, the platforming segments get a lot harder, is what I'm trying to say.
I mean, granted, I'm probably going to get lost in at least one of these platforming segments.
Yeah, probably. Oh, I guess I fell down.
I require medical attention.
Don't. Okay, that's that done. There's something out there. There's quite a few somethings out there. I'm pretty sure this is the way. Lost Soul. Okay. Dieg Ranak. Big data entry. Dark Viseroy to the Chaos Throne. Ranak has long served as one of Hell's emissaries on Earth, laying the foundation for the planet's inevitable invasion. In secrecy, Ranak has prepared the Helligate awaiting the omen of the Sixth Seal, that which signals the Age of Rapture, which will cleanse Earth as foretold by the Maker Prophets. Wait, is this a Warhammer 40k prequel? Ranak worked closely with Olivia Pierce during the development of the original Mars project, and since her death, has taken total control of the UAC. His promises of world power and everlasting life have corrupted the organization from within, absolving its employees of their moral conscience, accelerating the sacrifice of Earth in exchange for the lure of Argent energy and the promise of undying union with Hell. Dieg Ranak previously served the King of Argent in Uro as a sentinel priest, guiding the Argenta spiritual growth as a hallowed figure. After the betrayal, he abandoned his homeworld, working on behalf of the Khan Maker and personally overseeing the transformation of viable planets. Ranak has constructed a veritable fortress in the polar caps to protect him during his dark work.
I'm going to assume that the betrayer is Samuel Hayden.
This is a bit older than Samuel Hayden, by a few million years. that, I guess. Right. And from here, I can go forward. This way? How do I... Okay, so I'm here now. Not much else really. Just loot, fuel. That was not worth it. Do I have enough to spend on anything yet? Not quite. I can upgrade my suit though. Regenerating barras. Maybe. Actually, explosive piñatas. Too difficult. Okay, another weapon point. Need one more, I think. Okay, so I need to go down. Something. doesn't really help me, I don't think. Oh, of course it wasn't so easy. What did I just...
Well, I completed a secret encounter.
Congrats. At least the guy at the top tells you how many there are.
Yeah,